Hi, welcome to Survey Matters with Duncan-Parnell. My name is Mark White, and I'm the training manager with Duncan-Parnell, and today I want to talk to you guys about Internet-based Rover RTK. So what is that? Back in Trimble Access 2023.10, Trimble added something called Internet-Based Station Service, or IBSS. And what that does is allow you to transmit your corrections when you're doing RTK from the base to the rover using the internet. So why does this matter? Traditionally with RTK, we've used a radio at the base station, could be an internal radio or an external radio, and that radio broadcasts our correction information from the base to the internal radio at the rover. So now, the problem with radios is generally range. The power of the radio will only let the radio broadcast so far, and then environmental things get in the way, such as buildings, trees, and mountains, things like that, because radio is a line of sight technology, okay? So when we run internet at the base rover, that allows us to overcome those obstacles and get greater range. So we can set the base up and we can get farther away from it with the rover. So what do you need to do this? All right, so like I said, first you need at least access 2023.10 or higher on your data collector. The other thing you need is a Connect business account for Trimble Access. Now, this comes free as long as you have a valid warranty on the Trimble Access on your data collector. Okay, so if your warranty's up to date, the Connect business account is free. All you have to do is contact your dealer and ask them to get you set up on that. The third thing you're going to need is, once you have your Trimble Connect business account, you're going to need to assign a license to the guy that's working in the field so he can log into Trimble Connect on the data collector. So why is that important? The internet stream between the base rover is actually going to be housed in a Trimble Connect project that you're going to set up in Trimble Access. Okay, so that data stream is going to live in Trimble Connect. So the guy in the field has to have a license. It has to be logged into Connect. Then the fourth thing you need is you have to have internet access, right? It's internet-based rover. If you don't have internet access at the base or internet access at the rover, it's not going to work. Now, you know, here I've got a cell phone bag at the base station. So you can use something like a MiFi hotspot or a cell phone with a hotspot on it and just put it in a bag like this, or just simply leave it at the base station, right? These bags come in handy because then you can hang it right here on the base station. But you do need to have a wireless hotspot of some sort, be it a MiFi, be it a cell phone with a hotspot that you can leave at the base. Okay, then at the rover, you can put a SIM card in your TSC 5 or TSC 7 or TDC 6, whichever one you're using, or you could use a MiFi or a hotspot on your phone at the rover too, but both of them have to have internet access, okay? One of the great things about IBSS that Trimble did was they baked all the settings into Trimble Access, okay? That's what really makes it so easy. There's other internet base station services out there, but you have to know IP addresses, you have to have usernames and passwords, all that good stuff. The nice thing is all of that is baked into Trimble Access, so it's really easy to set up. And I've got a video that I did on how to set that survey style up, how to get all your settings done in there, and I'll leave a link for it down in the description so you can get more in depth with that. Okay, but the way it works is really easy to set up, really easy to use. I've got my base station set up on a control point. I've got my internet source here at the base. I've got my rover here, and I've got an internet source here for the data collector as well. So what I need to do is open up Trimble Access, and I have to log into Trimble Connect, right? Because I said that data stream is going to be housed on Connect. So I am already logged in. I click on here. If you're not, you just log into Trimble Access so you're on Connect, and I'll need to create a project. So I'll hit New here at Project, and I'll just call this IBSS, since we're doing Internet Base Station Service, IBSS, and tap enter and create. Okay, so I've got my project set up there. Now I'll go ahead and set up a job. Since it's a new project, doesn't have a job in it, it's gonna prompt me to go ahead and set up a job here in the software. All right, so I'm gonna call this IBSS again, keep it nice and simple. I am working in North Carolina. We are still a US survey foot, so I'm gonna set it up for US survey feet scale only, and then set up a coordinate system. you set it up for wherever you need to, right? With whatever units you need to. For the coordinate system, I'm going to tap on where it says scale of one, choose select from library. I am working in the United States, Nat 83. I'm not in Alabama. Like I said, I'm up in North Carolina. So I'll tap the list, hit the end down there on the keyboard, scroll up and choose North Carolina 3200. I'm going to use Geo 18 and keep my coordinates in grid for this. That's a different discussion. We'll just keep it in grid for this demonstration. And my project height around here is around 350 for an ellipsoid height. Anytime you see height in Trimble software, they're talking about an ellipsoid height. So here on the East Coast, that's roughly 100 feet below the ground surface. So I'll go with 350 for that. Enter and store. So now I've got my project created and my job set up. Now, okay. So I didn't have it on the controller because I just installed Trimble Access on this. So it's going to prompt me to download that. So we'll give it just a second to download the geoid model there. All right. So once the geoid model was downloaded, I'll tap store down here, tap next, and then I can just go ahead and accept. I'm not going to change anything else. Just a demo here. So I set up my job, set up a coordinate system there for it. So I'll just hit accept. So now I've got my project set up. And I've got my job set up, but I need to get that project on Trimble Connect. So I'm going to tap at the menu at the top left, tap on my project. It's highlighted there on the screen. So I'm going to tap the three dots at the top right of the screen, and I'm going to choose to upload that project to the cloud. Now it's going to ask me where I want to upload it to. In this case, I'm working in North America, so I want the North American server. And I am using my Connect Business for Trimble Access license. Remember, we have to have that. So I'll tap yes. And now that has been uploaded to the cloud. And you'll see on the screen there, there's a little cloud icon with a check mark next to it, okay? So now I'm ready to go ahead and start my survey. So I'll open the project, open the job, go up to the top left, tap measure, choose my IBSS survey style. And remember, I put a link down in the description on how to get all that set up for you. So we'll tap IBSS, and we're gonna start the base receiver just like we would if we were doing a regular RTK survey. So it's going to connect up to my receiver via Bluetooth, and that might take just a second. So I don't have a stream in here. So the first thing I need to do is hit the create button down at the bottom right and just name my stream something that's going to let me know it's my base station, right? So I'm going to type in my name and just call it base and hit create. So now that's being created in that Trimble Connect project on the cloud. So I'll cloud. So I'll accept that there. So now the first time you use a receiver with a hotspot or a phone, you will have to scan and find it. If you keep the same hotspot with the same receiver all the time, you only have to do this once because it's going to automatically look for that hotspot again. But the first time, we'll have to hit the scan button down at the bottom, and it's going to look for Wi-Fi sources in the area. Mine is the Verizon MiFi 7250, so I'll hit OK because it says it needs a password in there, so I'll hit OK there, put in the password for the device, and tap accept. Okay, so now we'll give it just a second to connect up there. You'll see the IP address loading at the top. And once it gets an IP address, I know I'm ready to survey. And like I said, after this, as long as you keep the same hotspot with the same receiver, you don't have to scan again. It'll automatically hook up. So I'll tap accept. And then I just got to put my point name in. Now I'm out here in front of the office, don't have a point here. So I'm just going to do a quick here position. I'll tap the black arrow, go to key in, put in point one, give it a code of base, and then hit the here button. But if you were out in the field on a known control point, just put in the point number of your control point and it'll automatically load that, right? So now I just have to start it. So when I hit start, now the receiver is sending its data to the MiFi and over the internet through Trimble Connect, so my base receiver can connect up to it as well. So I'll click OK. Let me just make sure my Rover's still on. It is. So now I'm just going to go back to the menu, tap measure, tap IBSS again, and this time I'll just measure points. So now the data collector will go ahead and connect up to the Rover. and it's building a source list. So what it's doing now is it's kind of like doing a network survey, right? It's looking for your mount point or your correction source, and here it's found the mark base that we just created. I know that's my base, so I'll tap accept. And it'll go ahead and open the correction source.
Waiting for information. Stop.
And now I'm just doing a regular survey at the rover, right? I can just go out and measure points. I can do stakeout. I can do a site calibration. I can do whatever I need to do here at the rover. You'll see I've got my vertical and horizontal precisions at the top with a green check because I'm fixed. So now it's just regular surveying, right? Except for I'm getting my corrections through the internet. So you'll see I have a globe with a green check mark turning there. And now my range is a lot later. So I'm going to do a video a little later where I'll set up on a monument and go measure a monument that's 7 or 8 miles away just to show you guys the accuracy based on the range you can get out of this. But this was just a quick overview of what internet-based rover is. And just to recap why you might need it. Traditionally, we've used radios when we're doing RTK, and that comes with range issues because it is line of sight and trees and buildings can get in the way. And then just the power of the radio. Sometimes we can only get a mile or so away, whereby using the internet, it gives us multiple miles we can get away from the base station, right? So we can get that longer range. We can cover larger sites. We can set up on a monument and go to a site that's a few miles away from the monument and do work like that. The other great thing is just that Trimble put all the settings into Trimble Access. So as long as you have Trimble Access 2023.10 or higher, all those settings are there. Again, there's a link in the description on how to set all that up, but it's all there. You don't have to have IP addresses and usernames and all that kind of stuff, okay? It's already built into the software there. So just remember, you do need a valid warranty on your Trimble Access because you need that Connect business account. And to get that set up, just contact your local Trimble dealer and they can get that set up for you. And then you do have to assign a license to the guy in the field that's gonna use this so that he can log in, create that project on Connect to house the data stream, okay? So again, IBSS and Trimble Access 2023.10 and higher is really easy to use. Everything set up in the software. You get the accuracy of having base rover, but with longer range now. Hey, thanks for tuning in to Survey Matters with Duncan Parnell, and I'll see you in the next one.